the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with Doug Allen.
Are you kidding me? They know they've got 3 minutes to get up to the drive-thru and back right now. Clock's running, all right? Don't make mine super size. Here's what we have going on right now. The rain showers are pushing off to the east at this point. Looks like nice clear skies here. Still there's some lingering clouds, but we're going to get rid of those. So precipitation has moved away, and the streams and creeks, which have been running high, are dropping nicely. The rivers, they'll be coming up as we go through the week, rises of several feet. But even when we add that to the current readings, that's going to keep people below the action stage. So we're looking okay. As we go through the night tonight, sky's becoming mostly clear, a little windy at times, 42 to 48 as we go through the overnight hours. We're going to be dropping down to about 29 degrees. In the morning, we'll be working up through 35 to 40 and climbing. Look at this. The first day of March, it will be a nice, brilliant day. A lot of sunshine, a little bit chilly, but by afternoon, temperatures are right about where they should be, and the average daytime high now is 44. So we'll be there, maybe a couple of degrees above that with mostly sunny skies. And, you know, just 13 days now until we spring ahead. And only 20 until the arrival of spring, not too far away. 40 degrees now, feels like 31 with a pretty brisk breeze from the north-northwest, blowing at 16 and gusting up to 25, and the barometer's on the climb, 29.94. The high today was 57, the low was 40, and we had just over half an inch of rain in the bucket today. And temperatures this morning had a pretty good launching pad. We started off, this is before lunchtime, close to 50 degrees. And then by the time we got into the afternoon, despite the fact that it was gray and rainy outside, our numbers had a chance to climb up close to 60. In fact, Gettysburg did pop up to 60 briefly this afternoon. And now that cold front is moving through the area. And so our temperatures are sliding and sliding. We're at about 40 around much of the valley. But you get west of the mountains and look at Johnstown at 25. Pittsburgh's in the 20s, 21. In Bradford right now. So that really chilly air is pushing in right behind this front that's just along the coast at this point. That's where the showers have moved, and all of the watches that had been posted on the tail end of this front where there's been some severe weather, they've pretty much all been dropped at this point. So the predictor shows high pressure building in for the first day of March. It's going to be a nice day. A little bit breezy out there, but as the high gets closer, the winds diminish. Skies stay clear. A chilly night tomorrow night. Then our next front pushes in on Wednesday, but very weak. Notice there's no precipitation with this. It's basically a reinforcing shot of some cooler air, and you'll see that change come your way Thursday in the 7-day forecast. But really not too bad a week is ahead. It's going to be drying out pretty nicely. Next shot is some showers. That's in the 7-day forecast too. So temperatures tomorrow morning are going to be chilly when you step out the door. First thing around, you know, 30 degrees, so a little bit below freezing. By afternoon, we're up into the 40s, and then a chilly night tomorrow night. You can see that cold air trying to make some inroads. Now Wednesday, we're back closer to 50 degrees, but then that front does make it through later Wednesday, so temperatures will get knocked back to about 40 on Thursday. It's, again, pretty close to average. We'll be right back to normal by Friday. Closer to 50 for Saturday. There's a chance of a shower. And about a chance of some showers and some rain coming our way Sunday. Maybe wrapping it up before we get into Monday. So a couple of nice days, really, to usher in the new month of March.
I was gonna say, tomorrow's March. Bring in the spring.
Rabbit, 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 rabbit.